Hi, this is Colin Hart from Big Tree Media. We're here today with Pro Sound Effects, exploring what to do and what not to do when you're recording submersions with a hydrophone. Let's check it out. One of the most common problems with using a hydrophone is how to keep it in place. Now, unless you have one of those really fancy, neutrally buoyant hydrophones, your mic will either sink or float. So that means I am stuck with figuring out how to either hold it in place or rig some fancy stand, rope, weird contraption. Tried mic stands in water. It can kind of work, but it's kind of a pain. So my favorite solution is a good old standby noodle trick. Here we have a basic economy, no frills, plain old pool noodle. And what I'm going to do with this is use it to help me float my hydrophone as well as reduce some handling noise, kind of like a shock mount. So I'm going to wrap this right around here twice and then tuck it under that first wrap, and that forms a what's called a clove hitch. And now what this allows me to do is adjust the length simply by rolling and pulling this, and it will set how deep the hydrophone will hang, and it minimizes some handling noise by bunching up there on that noodle. And there you have it, noodle mount. Now let's talk about how not to get a good submersion. When I was planning my first few, I posited that I could get a good recording one of two ways. The first was by placing the hydrophone barely under the surface, then submerging an object like my hand or this styrofoam egg carton that I'm using right next to the mic. This sounded okay, actually pretty cool, but I only got the ending of the submersion, the sound of the object already underwater. I was missing the transition I was looking for. My second method was to actually submerge the microphone with the object, so you would get a little of that transition from air to underwater with the mic. This sounded really weird because the water hitting the mic sounds really weird. So I played around in the pool with the microphone for a little bit, and I found that the sound I was really after was turbulent water with a lot of bubbles. So to accomplish this, I cut my hands and filled them with water, and I placed the microphone in the water as sort of a buffer. This way, I could record the action of the mic going into the water without changing the characteristics of its immediate environment. Then I submerged my hands and the mic and simultaneously ducked under the water myself, trying to bring as much air down with me as I could. I've found that many bubbles are the key to a good submersion. Another option would be to get an object that would hold some air in little pockets, like a plastic egg carton, that you could submerge under the mic. The key is to get a lot of air near or under the mic and let it out slowly over the performance of the action. Now, these aren't the only ways to get great sounds out of your mic. You need to play around, get creative, and have some fun. Thanks for watching. Sound effects.